So hello, my name is Jan Beran, and I would like to tell you something about making flatpaks from Fedora RPMs. But because of technical problems, it will be much shorter than I expected. But anyway, so first of all, I would like to say something about flatpaks and about the anatomy of flatpak and about how does it work and what is it? Because I don't know if you are familiar with that or not. Then I will step aside and speak about Fedora Silverblue, because that's one of the reasons why we decided to make Fedora Flatpaks. Then I will tell you something about Fedora Flatpaks and what are the advantages and what are the differences in comparison with classical flatpaks. And there will be some very short demonstration. So what is a flatpak? I'm not sure if you know it or not, but flatpak is some kind of container. And what's the idea behind it? I think most of you used RPM or Debian packages or something like that. And when you want some application, you have to download the application itself, but many dependencies. And it can happen that two or more applications needs one dependency, but in different versions. And Flatpak solves this problem by, as you can see here in this image, by making something what is called a runtime. And here in this runtime, there are libraries that are commonly used across many applications. And when you want to build a flatpak from the application, you just target specific runtime and you can use libraries which are there. But sometimes it can happen that you need some specific library or some different version of library, which is not in the runtime. So you just grab these special libraries, the application itself, and you make one container. And that's called flatpak. And these flatpaks doesn't target specific operating system, but specific runtime. That means that if you can run this runtime on your operating system, no matter if it is Fedora or Ubuntu or something like that, you can run the application as well. And the second concept of Flatpak is containerization. And that means that application in Flatpak cannot interact with the host system in any way. You have to explicitly say what this application can do. So for example, if you want to communicate over the internet, you have to explicitly say that this application will need an internet connection. Okay, Fedora Silverblue. Why I'm here speaking about operating system in talk, which is aimed for flatpaks. Because Fedora is, Fedora Silverblue specifically, is one of the reasons why we decided to make flatpaks from Fedora RPMs. Because Fedora Silverblue is a pretty solid immutable system, and that means you cannot, or you can, but it's not the preferred way, you shouldn't use RPMs and change the slash user and these folders which are commonly writable. So you need to distribute applications in containers. And we have two main ways how to distribute these applications. First way is Toolbox. There will be another talk about Toolbox, so I will skip it. And the second way are Flatpaks. But we wanted to use RPMs and advantages which RPM provides, so we decided to convert RPMs into flatpaks. How we do that? We use Fedora modularity concept. So if we want to convert some application into Flatpak, we first make a module, and we have to rebuild everything because Flatpak's layer in Flatpak application has its own file system and explicitly slash app, and you have to rebuild all the RPMs which are somehow involved in the application, because you cannot just grab a binary from slash user and move it to slash app and expect everything will work. And next, when you have a module done, you just convert it into OCI image. I will skip it. Here I can show you the application.yml and container.yml, which are two files we use for converting RPMs into Flatpaks. In application.yml, this is, we can say, a module MD file. It is a file which tells you how to make a module from RPMs. In this example, this is application.yml of Supertux. It's a one small game. And as you can see, Supertux has no special dependencies, so there is only Supertux itself. But in case of some bigger applications, there will be also some special dependencies. For example, here, I don't know if you see my cursor, but I hope so. Here you can see there is Flatpak runtime of version Fedora 33. Fedora runtimes are versioned according to the current system. So now we have Fedora 33 version, and then it will be Fedora 34. And container.yml is a file that tells the tooling how to make a container, or Flatpak if you want, from that module. The most interesting part is finish args, which tells you the permissions, as I said before. So for example, Supertux needs to communicate over the internet, play sounds, because there is a socket pulse audio. And it also needs, for example, show you something. So it needs these two sockets, Wayland and X11. Okay, and now there should be a demo. And I hope I will be able to share my terminal. So if we want to convert some application, we first need to generate application.yml, in this case, supertux.yml, and container.yml. That's done by the tool called FedMod, which is tool for handling modularity in Fedora, but it can be also used for generating these two files. So we pass RPM to Flatpak subcommand, and then we pass I see I have no time, so I will skip it. In full version, we should pass two arguments, flatpak common, which is a module where are some RPMs already built with a slash app prefix, so it can make your application.yml file smaller, because you don't need to rebuild everything. And we just pass another argument, flathub. And if you specify the name of the application in flathub, it will look for its manifest and copies permissions. Because permissions are not automatically derived from RPMs. You have to write them on your own, but this can make the process easier. You have something to start with. I will skip it because it can consume some time, and I have already have them. So it looks very similar to the two files I showed you. Here is the Flatpak runtime and Supertux RPM. And because I have very little time, I will skip it. The next step is to make a module and OCI image locally. It's done by Flatpak module local build. Flatpak module is similar to Flatpak builder for FlatHub packages. We have for Fedora, we have Flatpak module. It takes some 20 minutes, so I will skip it, but the result of that command is OCI image. And you can just install it and test it if everything is okay. I will switch back to presentation and hope everything will go smoothly now. So here in the slides, there is the process described a little more better, but I have no time to go through it. And if you are a little interested, I know this talk wasn't quite good, but if you are at least a little bit interested, you can visit these four links. There you can find some tutorials and better versions of what I have said before. And here you can, for example, find some packages, some RPM packages, which should be quite easy to convert into Flatpak. These two tutorials, first and third, they are some text version of this presentation, and they should teach you how to convert your application. And the last one is the same, but in Czech language. So if you can speak Czech, you can visit this one. Okay. And very briefly about the near future of Flatpaks. In current state, we would like to introduce Flatpaks also to RHEL, and we have some ideas about making Flatpaks from Copper repositories. And we would also like to include a community, because now only very few people are making Flatpaks. But the process is very similar to making RPMs. So you can definitely at least try it. And maybe, for example, if you maintain some RPM package, some application, you can try to convert it to Flatpak. And we would also like to automate the process, because now it's quite manual. Like you have to fire all these commands and see the result. We would like to be able to only passively watch the updates and rebuild everything in Fedora infrastructure. So this is the plan. And here in the presentation, there is also a command how to activate Fedora Flatpak repository in case you use Ubuntu or something like that and you want to try Fedora Flatpaks. So if you have some questions, are there any links for the Copper integration project? There are no links for the Copper integration because it's now it's only an idea. We are working on that, but it's nothing in the process now. Slides can be available. If you can go to Discord, I will share the link, or I will try to add to chat as well. How are the dist git branches named? Must you specify the runtime Fedora version? It would be nice to just pick it based on the branch name. What happens when a new Fedora branch is created? I'm not sure what are you, what branches are you talking about? If you mean branches of the runtime, it is specified by the current version. And if you are talking about something else, we can discuss it on Discord.